of questions to ask you. For the show of hands, how many of you wondered why I was wearing this scarf on my head? Well, today I'm going to be presenting to you my culture artifact, which is a headscarf, also known as a hijab in Arabic. Learning more about hijab will give you a better understanding of why Muslim women wear it. First, I'm going to be talking about what the cultural object represents, and then second, I'm going to give you a little information of why I identify with it. How do I put it on? Let me show you. Would you guys like to know how to put it on?
Okay.
Well, first, it's good. Isn't that pretty? Okay, and then grab. When you grab this side, you turn it into a kind of like a sandwich, I guess. I'll just demonstrate it myself. Like that, and then you put it right here. It's kind of hard when you have one scarf on. Okay, and then you grab two sides. You have to make sure that they are aligned. So you have two edges. And then you grab this part, make sure it's over your head. And then you have the two sides, and you fold them over. You grab, you turn it over, and you put it up to your, under your chin, and then that's where you grab, like a little fashionable safety pin, I guess. And then you just tie that, and then if, once that's tied, you grab the two ends, you cross them like this, and then you tie it into a knot, and then you fold it here. And then, but this part is tied, obviously. So that's how you put it on. If you guys want to try at home, go ahead. I'll let you borrow one. Okay, before, I'm sorry for that. before I want to let you know the purpose of what the hijab is, I just want to let you know that, well, you're probably wondering who can or cannot see my hair. Women can see my hair, but men can't. My family members can, but men like my dad and my brothers, yes, they have to. Okay, the purpose of the hijab is respect. Like, probably wondering, what does she mean, no, respect? Well, women, Muslim women wear the hijab so that men do not look at them in a sexual way. For example, if you were to see a woman who was very revealing, like short shorts, you know, tank tops, or whatever, and then you saw me covered, long shirts, these clothes, who would your attention most likely be on? Can you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Muslim women basically just want to be seen for our minds and our hearts rather than just the physical. Most people think that, some people think that physical might be everything, which is kind of sad. Now that I've told you a little bit about what this culture object represents, I'm going to talk about why I identify with it. When I was younger, I would go into my mother's room and I would open her drawers and I would find the brightest colored scarf or the most stylish one or the colorful, just bright, and I would just stand in front of the mirror and I would just practice. Sometimes it would look horrible, sometimes it would look good, and most of the time it would look like pretty bad. I didn't even know what I was doing. I started wearing the hijab at age 12. You're supposed to wear it at age 9, but I chose to wear it at age 12. Nobody forced me. I decided to, you know, wear it then because I wanted to follow my religion. I didn't really know the purpose of what the hijab was at that age. I didn't think of respect. I didn't think of, you know, religion or anything like that. I just thought about, oh, they're so pretty. I want to wear them. I want to, you know, take them out. I want to show them off. I was young, I didn't really know what I was even doing. Well, today we learned a little bit about the hijab, and first we talked a little bit about what the hijab represents, and second how I identified with it. Now, every time you see a Muslim woman walking around anywhere at the market, grocery store, or anything like that, just think of me in my presentation. If you have any questions or anything like that, feel free to ask me. I don't mind answering your questions.